All right, so this is the rotary compressor. I sourced another one to cut open. I mentioned, I think, in the last video that the one that I had didn't work out so well. Rotary, usually in air conditioners, things like that. So, nameplate. Let me try to zoom in on that a little bit, because I did get the information for this one too. So I got the door closed today, the garage door. It's very sunny outside and it was really causing filming problems. So there is the model serial number. Matsushita Electric is the manufacturer, which is actually Panasonic, or part of Panasonic. I'm not sure exactly how that works, but all the information's there. Model serial number, refrigerant, lots of information there. But I was also able to get the spec sheet for this compressor as well. So let me just reach over here and show you what I was able to find. So these sheets here, right off the internet, hot off the press, lots of information there. And then look at this, a exploded view, you know, detailing the ports, which port is which, lots of technical information there, electrical diagram there. Is the electrical diagram. But again, one important piece of information I got off of this, right there, winding resistance. So we're actually gonna check that again. So main, which would be the run, auxiliary, which would be the start. So we'll check that as well. So I'm just gonna show you the terminals here. So let's open up this electrical compartment, a little 5/16 nut on top here. And the terminals are actually identified on the top there. I don't know if you can see that, the CSR, although it also does show it underneath, I noticed. So I'll take this off and you can see the electrical terminals, overload, compressor overload, thermal overload. And then we take this off. Then these are the compressor terminals. And actually, you probably can't see it, but there's a C here, there is an R there, and there is an S there, identifying these terminals for me, which is really handy. So that does help. So I know which is the start terminal, which is the run terminal. So again, my trusty meter, I'm going to set it to ohms. Trying to get a good view there without the, so OL, because nothing's touching. And so what I'll do is connect one lead to the common, and I will connect one lead to the run. The sheet said 3.342, which is really a lot more detail than you're usually going to get, but I have 3.6, 3.7. So I'll say 3.6 with the average, with it bouncing up and down. So I'm in the ballpark. I'm doing okay for the run winding. Let's move this over to here. The sheet says 5.766. Oh, we're at 6, so very close. Though within our tolerance, so that's fairly close. So I can, it tells me that the windings are in decent shape. I'm actually gonna go start to run. And what you should get with the start, hopefully you've gone over this in your electrical theory, but what you should get with the start to run is the combination of the two windings together, the sum of 3.3 and 5.7, which is roughly 9. And what do we have here? 9.8, 9.7, 9.6. So So this is telling me that the windings should be okay. They look like they're okay. The other check that I can do is check to ground. So same thing, I'm gonna find a spot that might be ground, scratch that up a little bit so I get a good connection. And if there is a short to ground, I would get a reading because it's OL, tells me that there's no ground on that terminal. And I would do that with all three terminals. I don't have a short to ground in this compressor. But that would confirm to me that that compressor is okay. So that's the electrical check. Again, because you're just not gonna go and cut these open every day, probably never, unless you're doing a video like this or you have some sort of a concern that might be a problem. So just identify before I go any, discharge line off the top of the compressor, suction line. This is actually an accumulator to help protect the compressor a little bit. When I cut this open, I'm gonna cut all these off. So what I have to do with this, the windings are at the top, the compressor's at the bottom, held in by some spot welds. So what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to cut the base off and then grind the bottom in order to actually see the compressor part. I'll probably cut both ends. We'll see, just so I can show you that. I'm gonna stop the video just so that, and then do the grinding, and then I'll come back when I've done that. All right, just a quick view of the top end here. So I've got this all cut open. That's actually still really hot. So I'm just gonna throw these gloves on. So really all you're gonna see here is the compressor terminal connection and the motor windings. So open that up, and there you go. I'll try to zoom in here a little bit there. So the connector here, so these just push on the inside, but not like it's anything that you ever are going to. That's the inside of the pins. That's the outside of the pins. Better make sure, oh, I did it out of the camera. So outside, inside, that Molex connector just pushes on there. That's the connection. You can see the motor windings, the copper motor windings there. Rotor turns. And I'm just gonna flip it over. Okay, top end, bottom end now, sorry. Bottom end, I've flipped it over. I don't know if you can see the windings underneath there. You can still, if you look down and deep, the motors in there. Four bolts, 7mm. I've already taken them out, so I'm just gonna loosen them. This is a little bit snug, but this pops off. So this is a single vane or stationary vane, I guess you'd call it. How can I guess holding it up is probably gonna be the only way to show you that. So I'm gonna try to hold this up and turn it. Turn the, I can turn it quick enough. I think get my hands on that rotor there. There we go. I think I just had it on a line. So there you can see the rotor turning around. I think because I've got it out of alignment a little bit, it's locking up and not turning, but you can see how this part orbits and the vane slides in and out. And again, this vane's not moving very freely, but so that's the one style of rotary compressor. I wish I could get that to move a little freer, but I think because all the grinding that I've done, I've probably tightened things up a little bit here. It doesn't want to move right now. But anyways, I think you get the idea of the inside of that rotary compressor. Okay, I got this freed up a little bit, so just so you can see, it gets to a spot and then it gets stuck, which is probably what the failure of this compressor was. But wait, you can see that offset ring there, how it goes around in a circle. It does keep going in the same direction. It doesn't go back and forth. It keeps going in one direction. This vane is spring loaded, which you can't see the spring back there, but there's a spring back there and it's not springing either. So a couple of mechanical issues with this, which is probably why it's sitting here cutting pieces right now. So there you can see how that would keep going. It gets to about that spot and then it jams. And then I really gotta push it to get it. And then when I go the other way, the same thing right about there, it gets stuck. So that is what would have caused this to become scrap. So there you go, rotary. So stationary rotary vane. When you see the automotive compressor later, you will see the rotary vane.